Mohammed Makhdi Fazali fled Afghanistan after his cousin and friend were killed by the Taliban. He worried that he could be next, so he came to Australia by boat in 2013. But his refugee claim was rejected, and he was told it was safe for him to go back to Afghanistan.
Yeah, the response from Australian government was, Afghanistan is safe for you.
He's lived in the Australian community on six-month bridging visas for the past 9 years, having to apply for a new visa each time while working to support his family, who also fled the Taliban to Iran.
Because they have no any visa over there as well. They are living illegal over there.
In Sydney, Mohammed Salim was found to be a refugee, but he was only offered a temporary protection visa. That means he's had no right to travel or bring his wife and children, who remain in Afghanistan.
They keep asking me, when you're going to come home, when you're going to come home, please come to home. I don't have answer. What should I say?
Despite the devastating scenes in Kabul this week, Scott Morrison today said that anyone currently in Australia after arriving by boat will not be allowed to stay.
Those who have not come to Australia the right way and are on temporary visas in Australia, they will not be offered permanent residence in Australia. That will not change. I want to be very clear about that. I want to send a very clear message to people smugglers in the region that nothing's changed. I will not give you a product to sell.
Of the more than 5,000 Afghan asylum seekers currently in Australia, over 4,000 were granted protection, but only temporarily. Refugee advocates say that all of them should have been granted permanent protection years ago.
They refuse people on the basis that they could return to Afghanistan and, from their perspective, live safely in Kabul. Now, we have been saying for years that that is not something people can do, that Kabul should not be considered a safe city.
No end in sight for an increasingly desperate situation. Aaron Fernandez, SBS World News.